Wise man, what is the official way? How are you supposed to put these on?
They actually printed up a thing on the front so that you can see that's going to be right side up.
Not on the offshore special I got. This one's got extra asbestos in it.
Yeah, that is a very weird design.
I'll give you guys a 2-minute warning. He hasn't come down yet. Another 2 minutes.
You're not there, like, with the iPhone.
Well, I have to tell you, I've never seen any actual screen design.
We're on the air.
Yeah. Now, did you want my recorder?
That's probably why.
I forgot to say, you had to come to the
Did he have a working relationship with him?
book. I'll see it in the back.
Good morning, everybody, and thanks for tuning in to our first Henri update of the day. As a reminder, we will be back here live at 4 o'clock to give another update. Staying up to date with the latest information is the best way to keep you and your family safe during the storm. While we had a beautiful sunny day yesterday, the storm has now approached, and we are starting to feel the beginnings of its effects. I just came from a walkthrough of our Emergency Operations Center, and our latest update continues to show that Rhode Island will feel heavy impacts of high wind, loss of power, and flooding. We expect that to start happening over the next 1 to 2 hours. Yesterday, we asked you to prepare for the storm. Today, I'm asking you to stay home. Let me repeat that. I'm asking you, Rhode Island, to stay home until this storm passes. This is not the time to go out and see the waves or explore downed trees. This is the time to stay home and stay safe. And my dad always told us, better safe than sorry. If you venture out, you are not only putting your own life at risk, but you're endangering our first responders. And I want to thank all our public safety officials, first responders, and electric crews who are working around the clock to keep us all safe. I talked to a couple of the crews that are going to be coming up from Pennsylvania today, and so we know that the National Grid is really bringing in a great deal of resources, and we want to keep those resources coming. So I've ordered a ban on states' roadways for all motorcycles and all tractor trailers, except those carrying emergency supplies, starting at 11 a.m. until further notice. We have restricted access to Newport, Pell, and Jamestown Verrazano bridges for house trailers and RVs, empty enclosed trailers, or any vehicle that, in the opinion of law enforcement personnel, may not safely cross the bridge, will be prohibited from traveling the bridge. Motorists who are denied passage will be assisted with safely turn around assistance. As of 9:30 this morning, there were around 8,000 power outages, with the overwhelming majority of those outages being in South Kingstown, Warren, Bristol, and Little Compton. We are expecting extended power outages across the state throughout the day. And I've shared this concern directly with President Biden and with the National Grid. The president committed to get additional utility workers to Rhode Island to help us get residents and businesses connected back to power as soon as possible. Since we are expected power outages across the state, I want to remind you and some important safety tips if your power goes out. That being said, make sure phones and electronic devices are charged. If your power goes out, keep your refrigerators and freezers closed and open them sparingly to preserve temperature. If you have a generator, only use it outdoors 20 feet away from the windows. If you are experiencing a loss of power, you can report it to National Grid by calling 1-800-465-1212. Again, that's 1-800-465-1212. 1212. And I'll continue to work today being escorted with state police around the state to take a look at the most troubled spots to make sure that we have a first eye look, a bird's eye view of the issues that are in front of us so that we can be quick and we can make sure that we're keeping people safe, and also with a look at the recovery strategy, which is going to be so important to the people who live in the state, as well as our small businesses and our businesses around the state. So that, I would like to turn it over to Lieutenant Governor Matos so that she can communicate to some of our Spanish-speaking individuals that are in the state to give them some direction as well. We're fortunate to have the Lieutenant Governors with us here today. Lieutenant Governor.
Thank you, Governor. I'm just going to do some highlights in Spanish. Le quiero recordar a toda la comunidad que el gobernador nos dijo ayer que ayer era el día de prepararse. El día de prepararse era ayer. Hoy es el día en que necesitamos que todos ustedes se queden en casa. Necesitamos que dejen las vías libres para que el personal de emergencia pueda hacer su trabajo. Tenemos que evitar el ir a... irse a querer y a ver cómo está el agua, y todo eso no es prudente ahora mismo. Algunas cosas que queremos recordarles es quédese en su casa, manténgase al día escuchando las noticias, las últimas noticias que se están pasando a través de la social media del gobernador y de mi página también en los medios sociales. Ahora mismo, si quiere continuar escuchando la información simultáneamente en español, puede conectarse y seguirnos en Facebook, y tenemos a Rosa de Castillo haciendo la traducción en vivo ahora mismo. Recordándose, por favor, quédense en casa. El gobernador también ha puesto un límite a los camiones de cargo, al igual que a las motocicletas. Ahora mismo no están permitidos, así que por favor, no salga motocicleta y los camiones de cargos no son permitidos en nuestras carreteras ahora mismo. Estamos esperando que va a haber mucha pérdida de electricidad y que va a haber muchas inundaciones y los vientos muy fuertes. Así que, por favor, queremos expresarle una vez más que se queden en casa. Hoy no es el día para salir, el día de preparación era ayer. Mantenga a su familia segura y quédese en casa. Con eso voy a pasar el micrófono al director Pavas.
Thank you, Lieutenant Governor. Okay, so today our message is simple. Stay safe, stay home, stay off the road, and stay tuned. We're beginning to feel the impacts of now Tropical Storm Henri, but the worst is yet ahead. It's early. We have tropical storm conditions for the rest of the day. This is going to be a long duration event, as we've been reporting for a couple of days now. We're fortunate to have teams of experienced emergency professionals led by the governor, and we ask that you take our directions that are led by the governor very seriously. As I said, the storm is just beginning to make landfall and move across Rhode Island, so please remain vigilant and safe, and stay safe and stay tuned. Now is the time to shelter in place. The storm has the potential to bring damaging wind and damaging water across the state, not just coastal communities. Damaging wind gusts, storm surges, and power outages remain strong possibilities all throughout the day and into tomorrow. But the amount of precipitation alone is the cause of concern. Water is the enemy with these storms. Flash floods, flooded roadways, intersections, and other water-related perils are very real possibilities. We already have crews standing by to assist with roadside emergencies, but they will need to access our roadways, so we ask you to stay off the roads. As best as possible, continue to remain informed as to what is happening. This continues to be an evolving situation. It can move quickly. And we will provide updates. Please listen to the radio and TV for information. We'll also be sending out updates on social media. Please sign up for Code Red if at all possible, and on the REMA website for text and email updates. Avoid using the phone except for emergencies. Keep friends and family informed of your local location, And if you have elderly people or people requiring special care, remain in communication with those folks as you are able and ensure they are safe. Additionally, as I said yesterday, we've activated United Way 211. We thank them for their assistance. So if you have questions regarding the storm, you can call 211 and get your questions answered. That's all I have. I have the panel up here. Happy to take questions.
Dr. Mathis, are you aware of any injuries? And also, does anyone need, has anybody needed to use the Red Cross emergency shelters yet?
Take that first part, no injuries. The second part, there are minimal folks in shelters right now. I think there are 15 in Providence, and then single digits throughout the other ones scattered throughout the state.
What's the status of Rhode Island government tomorrow? Is it closed, open for only essential employees?
Right now, TBD, depending on the damage of the storm. Governor, you want to speak to that at all?
Yeah, we're going to take a close look at that later in the day, and then we'll make a decision based on where we are later in the afternoon.
Colonel Manning, what are your troopers observing as far as motorists or pedestrians on the coast, people heading down there, people getting in the water? What are you seeing?
So I personally went out early this morning, traveled the coast from westerly up, and the messaging we gave yesterday to the public was stay home, and thankfully they did. So it's very light traffic, very minimal areas where pedestrians are walking the beach or standing on the seawall. The one area of concern that universally all the chiefs have on the coastal communities are surfers, and they're staging in areas across South County and coastal areas, Jamestown and so forth. That is a major challenge to public safety during a storm, whether it's a winter storm or a summer storm. They go in the water, and on occasion they would need assistance, and then firefighters would have to go in to rescue them. So we're asking all surfers, please use your head, do not go in the water until the storm is over.
Is there an anticipated peak storm surge?
Later today, as the storm makes its approach towards right. The...
What's the estimate currently?
Sometime around 2 o'clock, I think. I think we got lucky a little bit with the timing of the storm, mm-hmm. with the tide. So it looks like it'll be not on the high tide, but on the going out low tide.
And any estimate as to the size?
I'm still getting 3 to 5 feet. Mm-hmm. I haven't seen anything over that. And the other thing I'd like to just draw attention to is all the folks from FEMA are here today helping us. You saw the truck outside when you pulled in. The FEMA Incident Management Assistance Team is here. A representative is here if you have questions for FEMA.
What is the area of the state that you're most concerned about right now?
South County, South Coast.
Block Island right now? Is it what
Block happened? Island was just in communication with them. They're getting a little hammered right now, but they're in good shape, ready to go.
Director, I believe yesterday you said 11 o'clock was going to be the peak. Has that shifted a little bit in terms of timing when we'll see the worst of this weather?
Yeah, I think it's slowed down a bit. So it's pushed it back. That's why I was saying it's a long duration event, because as the storm approaches, it wasn't about 18 miles an hour, but as it's coming closer to the coast, it's slowing down. So that means more rain, still in the vicinity of 2 to 4 inches, strong storm surge, and wind over a longer period of time.
In terms of power outages, we're already yep. seeing numerous customers without outages, without power.
No, no, they can't. They can't go up in the bucket truck safely, so they can't get up and help with the power outage now. I have National Grid here who can speak to that.
Thank you, Director.
Yes, sir.
As the Director said, and as the Governor said, this is going to be a long duration event, and it's really important that we take an event of this magnitude one step at a time. First and foremost, our top priority today is public safety, so we'll be working really closely with Colonel Manning and his teams. Making sure that we clear all 911 calls and ensure that the public remains safe. After that, we'll be working on damage assessment. As we said yesterday, that'll be a good 12 to 24 hour period to really fully understand the impact of the storm. And then following that phase, we will begin restoration in earnest. We do have a number of crews, as mentioned yesterday, pre-positioned throughout the state. More will be arriving today and tomorrow, so we're well prepared, but we do need to brace for a very challenging period ahead.
Director, what is the status of the National Guard right now and or potential deployment?
It's a great question.
I'm not familiar.
Thanks. Good morning, everybody. As far as Rhode Island National Guard goes, we have approximately 130 personnel that are on duty right now. As we mentioned, Friday and Saturday, our primary mission sets are threaded and synthesized with what Mark had shared with us in terms of high water. So we're working high water, high wheel vehicles. We know that debris clearance could be an area that we may need to support, but we stand firmly in support of the agencies that have been presented today. We also will be monitoring the storm. Our own operations center is up and running 24/7 down at our headquarters in East Greenwich. And we will be standing by to support as needed.
Any last questions?
What are your expectations for inland communities, for like Providence, all the way going north? What are the expectations for this storm, for those communities?
As far as impacts from the storm?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's going to come straight up. It looks like it's going to touch over Block Island, come up through maybe near Charleston, and then go straight up through the state. So as it does that, it's going to weaken, right? But it's still going to be very windy. So we anticipate power outages all the way up to Rhode Island.
Any last question? We'll be back at 4 with another briefing.
Governor, what are your personal plans to tour the state and inspect the situation or otherwise monitor things?
Yeah, so I think it's important that we see exactly what's going on in the ground. We'll be doing it safely with our state police's escorts. But we plan to be visiting Westerly, Narragansett. And as you know, as time goes out between now and 4 o'clock, press event here, we'll you know, visit areas that make sense to make sure that we know what's going on. I think that not only I think it's been repeated over and over again. You know, let's be safe, rather safe than sorry. And but again, we're also preparing for the recovery. We know that Rhode Island in the past has had issues down in Newport with gas recovery. We know what that means to the residents. We know that what that means to the seniors that rely on air conditioning during 90 degree weather. And so we're as focused today on the safety issues, and that's why we're saying people stay home. Let's be safe. Let the people do the work that that's behind me that know how to do the work. I'm taking their guidance as well. And then we want to be really concerned about being prepared to make sure that the state recovers from this storm as quickly as possible.
Do you anticipate asking for a declaration of disaster or any other kind of federal assistance?
Well, right now, we did that yesterday, and the president did sign a declaration that we sent to them through Director Pappas. So right now, we're as protected as we want to be at the moment, and we thank the president for signing that that order.
We're hearing from mayors on social media and on traditional media. Do they have an autonomy, or are you coordinating directly with various municipalities with any decisions that they're making?
We're in direct contact with all the municipal leaders, as you would expect as me being a former mayor. That continues, and I believe we have a call with them sometime around 1 o'clock to kind of get an update. I think it's right in that time frame.
Any requests for help yet?
No, I've talked to the community leadership that is going to get hit the most. They're preparing as we are right now, and it's kind of as a, you know, it's, right now it's on an as-needed basis, and that's why we're going to be reaching out to the communities throughout the state. On the coastal side, as the director said, where with the impact we expect to be the hottest hit.
Great. Thanks, everyone. We'll see you at 4. Thanks so much.
Governor, I was going to ask you whether the travel restriction is likely to remain voluntary or whether it will be mandated and enforceable.
Yeah, right now, we just outlined the bridges. That's clearly going to be under supervision. That's where the local enforcement is going to make some local decisions that they had, I believe, down in Narragansett, taking the Ocean Drive away over that stretch there. So yeah, locally, they're going to be able to make those determinations, and right now, we've stated where we are at the moment.
But for the moment, you...
Motorcycles off the road, tractor trailers that are not providing emergency supplies, they're off the road as well. And then we'll take a look at what's going on. But again, if you don't have a reason to get out of your house, don't be leaving your house. This is where you want to be safe. And we, like I said, better safe than sorry.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you. Are you live still? Can I go by, sir?
Yeah.
Yeah, I go back to the problem.